Hello everyone and welcome for talk about developer productivity with JHipster application generator. What is this talk about? This talk is about productivity of development team with from different perspectives, with the developer's perspective, business people perspective, and from customer's perspective. After we talk a little bit about productivity, we'll go 101 on the JHipster itself. We'll talk about promises of JHipster's productivity for developers and the pitfalls of those promises. And lastly, we'll show a really quick demo, and maybe we can do a fully working application in that demo. About the speakers, Mihael Sedmak, superstar developer and solutions architect, currently working at Bytecraft. Unfortunately, Mihael couldn't be with us today, but I will try my best and do his part of the presentation also. As for me, my name is Danijel Mitar, and I'm currently working as Java developer at King ICT. A few notes on productivity. For starters, what is productivity? Well, it's not an easy question to give an answer on, because it's a highly controversial, opinionated, and subjective topic. If you ask a developer what he thinks is productivity, he will probably tell you that for him productivity is how fast he can code, how easy to use are the tools he is using, and how good is the technical stack he is using. If you ask business people what they think productivity is, you will get another kind of answer. They will probably tell you that productivity for them is how many features you are delivering in some iteration or how much work you do in some kind of time. If you ask customer what they think productivity is, you will get yet another type of answer, because customer thinks that development team productivity for them is how many features are they delivering to the end users, are those features fulfilling customers' expectations, and is there any bugs present. So what can we do in order to improve our productivity, and how we can measure are we productive or not? Well, we can include some metrics, so metrics for the win. But okay, what should we measure? Should we measure how fast is some people coding? How good are the tools he is using? How many story points are we delivering in some iteration? Or maybe we can start measuring dryness, not reinventing the wheel, code quality, and feelings. Okay, but what have feelings got to do with it? Well, everything, because customer satisfaction is a feeling, and team satisfaction is a feeling. If you have a team that is not satisfied and it's not motivated, you will certainly not have productive team. They will not produce features for the end users, so your customer will also not be satisfied. And what can we do about it? Well, we can measure those feelings. Team feelings we can measure inside some kind of retrospectives, or maybe you can use Spotify squad health check model. And hopefully you will need to use retrospectives at the end of each iteration, where team would go on and discuss what they did, what was good in the last sprint, what was bad, and what should they improve in order to increase their productivity. Hopefully, if the team is satisfied, they will be more productive. They will improve their delivery time, delivery quality, and customer will be satisfied also. But how we can know that customer is satisfied? Well, we can use questionnaires about the delivery quality. Is it on time? Is it fulfilling features, expectations? Are there any bugs present? Or we can see how customer perceives team performance. Okay, maybe JHipster can also help, especially in the terms of dryness, not reinventing the wheel, and code quality. But before we dig deeper, let's go 101 on JHipster. JHipster is an open source library started back in the 2013 by Julien Dubois, and it's hosted on the GitHub. It's a combination of three very successful web frameworks, Bootstrap, Angular, and Spring Boot. But it's very, very opinionated. It's trying to use best practices, but it's very, very opinionated in using those practices. It's built on top of Yeoman code generator, and it uses your webpack and yarn. Community of JHipster is very vital and very active. Community has built around 60 additional modules, which include support for React, Vue, or even Ionic, so you do not need to use only Angular. As for React, React support is officially announced starting from version 5 of JHipster. But is JHipster successful? And if it is, how much? Well, it won the Duke Choice Award last year, so pretty successful. And in our opinion and from our experience, JHipster is the giant driver in terms of application setup, structure, configuration, convention, code quality. So yes, it can help certainly in the terms of developers' productivity. What are the promises of JHipster productivity? Well, JHipster will generate a fully blown working application. You will get everything. On the front end, you will get Angular single page application with HTML forms for every entity you need inside your application. You will get database, even liquid-based change sets for versioning the database. You'll get repository layers, service layers, controller layers. Spring security will be pre-configured. And everything, pretty much everything what you need for typical today's application will be generated and ready to use. That generated code will try to use best practices, how much opinionated they are. They think that it's the best practices. And one thing, they also use always GitHub issue tracker to discuss what are those best practices. And in one issue track, Oliver Gierke from Spring suggested for JHipster team to use package by feature instead of their conventional package by layer. But the JHipster team decided that his arguments were not good enough, and they stick to the packaging by layer. If you want to start developing with JHipster, you will need to install some things like JHipster itself, Node.js, Java, Maven, Gradle, all sort of additional tools, and that can be a very tedious process. So JHipster team made development environment inside Vagrant box, which is based on Debian Linux distribution, which has everything pre-installed, configured, and ready to use. All you need to do is power up the virtual machine, type JHipster, and the application will be generated for you. For those of you who do not know what Vagrant is, later today I will give a talk about the Vagrant, so you can come and learn what Vagrant is and how it can help you boost your performance. Inside the generated application, there will be configuration with a production profile, which is highly optimized for use in production-like environments. You will get development profile, which is typically for working on local workstations, and there will be this production configuration with optimized configuration for production environments. But not everything is shiny. There are some pitfalls of this productivity. Not only that JHipster allows you to generate your application, you can use JHipster generator in later stages, especially if you know how your entity relationship model will look like up front. Then you can use it to create your entities, and with the help of JHipster generator, you will generate all of those entities annotated with JPA annotations, repository, controllers, and HTML forms for all of those entities. But I would recommend you use that kind of generation only if you know upfront how your database model will look like. If you do not know how it will look, if you want for your DB model to evolve as you go, then maybe you should not use JHipster generator in the later stages of development, because you will need to adjust your code in order to use it, and that's just not the preferred way. The tool should be helping us, not the other way around. Also, there is one thing that bugs me. It's questionable test quality. When I looked inside the test, by the way, you get the tests generated also, not just the code, but the test quality is just not as good as I would liked it to be. I like my tests to be concise, readable, good code quality, because for me tests are as equally important as the code itself. If we have good tests, then we are always certain that our application will be working. But their test quality is just not so good. They have methods with different names, but the methods are testing the same, so probably some kind of copy-paste error. They have some test methods that are actually not testing something. They have just the setup part, but no asserts, no nothing. So I hope they can improve on that part. But the most questionable thing for me is build per environment versus build once. I always like to build my applications once, so I have one binary which I deploy across multiple environments. When I deploy one binary to the development environment, it works. I go to the testing environment, it works, and I'm certain that when I deploy that same binary on the production, it will work also. If something is not working, then it's not the binary because we tested multiple times. If we build per environment, how we can be sure that our binary will be successfully deployed? I mean, how crazy is that? We are building for the production and we are deploying binary we have never tested. It's just like playing a Russian roulette and not knowing if you will shoot yourself in the leg until you pull the trigger. Unfortunately, JHipster uses build per environment approach. They expect you, while executing build command, that you pass the parameter of environment you will be deploying to. So probably the first thing you would like to do is to change that so you can build only once. Now, let's go and try to make some fully working application in this time we have left. What will be the topic of application? Let's try and make application which will manage schedule here for Javantura conference. And let's say that we know our entity relationship model upfront. We'll need to store information about speakers, lectures, and the schedule itself, and maybe some additional things about the lecture like type, level, category, and tracks. What do you think, is it doable in about 15 minutes? Yeah. Maybe it is, maybe it is not. Let's try and see. We'll do our best. Okay, before I start, let me just say that here I'm using Vagrant JHipster box, so everything is pre-installed, configured, and ready to develop JHipster applications. Okay, let's create directory to work in. And it's as simple as executing JHipster command. Okay, it will start JHipster generator. And the first question we need to give answer on is which type of application we would like to create. We can choose between monolithic, microservice application, microservice gateway, or JHipster server. For this, we will choose monolithic. Name of application, okay, Javantura. No, we would not like to use JHipster registry. For authentication, you can choose between stateless JVT, stateful HTTP session, and open out. We'll stick to JVT. SQL database, production database, Postgre. You can choose different databases for production and development. For development, let's say H2 with in-memory persistence. Hibernate second-level cache, okay, with Hazelcast, which is distributed caching. For building the backend, let's say Gradle. No other additional technology. Angular 4 for frontend. No SAS. No internationalization. No additional testing frameworks. And would you like to install other generators from the JHipster marketplace? We won't install any, but let me just show you which options you have. There is really plenty of options. We can see here Ionic, Bootstrap Material Design. Well, community is really active and you have a lot of additional options available to you. Okay, now JHipster generates all the files and starts installing front-end dependencies, but because this will download practically the whole internet, we will abort this operation, and I have already generated application with the same properties we have chosen right now, so we can start from there. And you will have to trust me on that. If you see git status, okay, nothing. And in git log, there is just one initial application, initial commit by JHipster generator. Okay, we have initially generated our application, and where to go next? Well, because we have we know our database model up front, we can immediately start by designing our entities. And JHipster also has JHipster domain language and studio for working with that domain language, where you can design your entities and describe relations between them. It's a web interface, and here you can see I have already designed entity relations for this application, so we will just go through all of the setup. We have entity keyword, which we use for creating entity. We can even use attributes like required max length. There is also IntelliSense for working inside this studio. There is also support for enum, which I used for lecture type, level, and tracks. And finally, when you finish designing your entities, you can describe relations between them. You can choose between one-to-one, many-to-one, and many-to-many and one-to-many relations. Here we have one-to-one between schedule and lecture. We have many-to-one between lecture and category, and many-to-many relation between lecture and speaker. If you are just starting with JDL Studio, here you have help, where you can see how it works, and also here you can have you have language reference, when you can see additional details. But let's just download this file and use it in order to generate those entities with JHipster. It's as easy as typing JHipster, import JDL, and point to our file, and JHipster will now start generating our entities. Okay, we have conflict here inside master XML Liquibase chainset. If we press enter, we will see all of the options with description, and here is nice option at the D, which says difference between old and the new. Okay, because this is just the first time we are generating and we have no code modification, JHipster will practically only add new lines to all of the files, so we'll say okay, overwrite this and all other files. When JHipster creates all of the files, it will start Webpack build, and while we are waiting this build to finish, we can immediately start backend, so we do not waste any time. And while we are waiting all these operations to finish, we can just quickly browse through all of the files JHipster created for us, where you can see that it created Angular TypeScript files, HTML forms, Java classes, repositories, services, and everything needed for our entities and for our interface to work, user interface to work with those entities. Okay, while we are waiting for these operations to finish, we can go to we can focus more on this documentation, where you can see this link, which points to the additional documentation about JHipster domain language. Here you can see practically every information you would need in order to design your entities. But not only that, JHipster has really, really elaborative and extensive documentation, where you can see how you can set up your environment and start working with JHipster, how you can use it with microservices, how to use it in development, some tips and tricks, some production advices on setup. And if you would like to start with the JHipster, I highly recommend that you first read all of this. It may seem that it has a lot of text to read, but it's not the case. You would need only a few hours to read all of this, and you will have a lot of details, and you will know how to start with JHipster. Okay, frontend has finished. We can start frontend. Backend is also up. Okay, while we are waiting, we can say, I can show you this. Okay, so JHipster team is also very, very active around code quality. So they're using cloud version of Sonar, where they track their quality gate. You can see they have very, very good code coverage, around 75%, very little code duplication, zero bugs, zero vulnerabilities. Quality gate indeed is failing, but it's failing only because they have less than 80% of code coverage. Maybe 80% is too much. It really depends on what you think that is important to test inside your application. But I sincerely hope they will increase code quality inside their tests, because it's just too low. Yes, and one other thing, I was surprised that their main Java class wasn't annotated with its Spring Boot application annotation, but it indeed is Spring Boot application, so I don't know why that's the case, but when I tried to put Spring Boot application annotation on top of that class, everything broke, nothing was working, so who knows. Okay, frontend has started, so we can see what we got. Without a single line of code, did we did a good job? Come on. Okay, so we can see we have entire user interface, and we can log inside of application. When we log in, we see this drop down inside Navbar which says entities, and if we expand, we see all of the entities created for us. If we go to category, we see a table with categories. We can create new categories, so let's try and create new category. Okay, let's say Java Web, and let's create a few more. Okay, maybe. And when we create categories, we can see additional details. We can edit, delete. Practically all of the CRUD operations are available for us. Let's move on to the lecture. Let's create a lecture. Okay, let's say presentation with demo, something in between. Category, we will need here we see ID, not the name, so that's one thing we can improve, but let's not complain too much. Let's go on to create speakers. Okay. Okay. Let's go back to lecture and add speakers to those lectures. We have multi-select also available for us for many-to-many relations. And finally, we can create a schedule for this lecture. Let's say hall A, and let's say lecture with this ID. Okay, we can now see in the table that we created a schedule for lecture 1051. If we click on the view, we can see additional details, and if you press on the ID of the lecture, we can see details about the lecture and so on for the speaker and for the category itself. So practically in just a few minutes, we generated entire application, and it's fully usable and working application. Maybe a few things we can improve, so in order that we do not need to guess what this ID presents, but it would not take us much time. What else did we get? Well, if we expand administration, we can see here user management. So we have fully working user management with all of the CRUD operations for manipulating with users in our application. If we move on, we can see metrics. So JHipster will build this nice dashboard where we can see how much memory is our application using, thread, garbage collection status of HTTP requests. And not only that, JHipster will also monitor execution time of our backend methods. And here you can see how much time is spent on each of the backend method. Health checks with disk space and database status. All of the configuration properties used in our application can be seen in this screen. You can also use the search. Let's try and search for Liquibase. Okay, we can see now configuration for Liquibase. audits where we can see, okay, user admin authenticated successfully. Logs. Here we can dynamically change log level of each logger inside our application. API Swagger generated documentation for our API, and here we can see how we can use each of the resource, practically basic Swagger documentation, and finally database, which is basically H2 console for our database. User can change his settings, his password, and log out. So we have seen how in just a few minutes we can build fully working application with the help of JHipster, and we didn't even need to write a single line of code. So how crazy is that? Okay, that would be everything. If you have questions, I'll be glad to answer them. Yes?
Secondly, a question, I think the obvious one when you have generators. What happens if you change something in the code and then regenerate the project again?
Good question. Yeah, JHipster uses special comments inside Java code, inside JavaScript code. They call these comments needles. And it's just basically a placeholder where they will generate the new code. So you can modify the code, but you should never remove those comments because they will place newly generated code at the place where that comment is. Is it okay?
So if I understood it correctly, you need to add the comments or the system
adds it? No, system adds it. First
okay,
time you
but
generate
you cannot remove the comments.
If you remove the comment, JHipster cannot place lines in that place.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so we've seen an example of a master view implemented as a table. Is it so? You could imagine an application with many more entities and tens or hundreds of such tables available. And so if you wanted at a later point to modify this master view across the application, is it generated code for each entity, or is it with JHipster, is it a template that's applied to each entity? Do you understand what I'm asking?
Yes. Okay. They're using templates for initial application generation, but for later stages they are generating new code.
In your answer would be that you'd have to go through each entity and modify the generated code to get the desired behavior, as opposed to just modifying
one
place.
If you want to change entity after you generated it and you later want to add additional column, you mean on that?
So never mind. We can clear it out later.
Okay. Any more questions? Yes. Well, you možda ne želiš generirati kod u tom slučaju. A nije svaki alat za sve, ne? Sve ima svoje mjesto i vrijeme. Ovo, mislim, JHipster generator je super i super ga je koristiti. Pogotovo ako imaš neku manju aplikaciju, ako trebaš napraviti nešto ovakvoga, u 5 minuta si gotov, ali ako imaš ono veliki entity relationship model i sve, vjerojatno želiš imati puno veću kontrolu nad svime što radiš. I ja osobno kad bih sljedeći put koristio JHipster, koristio bih ga za inicijalno generiranje aplikacije, ali dalje više ne. More questions? Okay, thank you and good day.